Welcome back! My name is Baller Scuba. This is Video Games Over Time. We are still in 1984. Today, we're going to talk about Kung Fu Master. The story of Kung Fu Master takes us to Jackie Chan. Jackie Chan is a Hong Kong actor and martial artist. We briefly mentioned Jackie Chan in our video on Yi R Kung Fu when we talked about Bruce Lee. Jackie Chan started acting as a child, first appearing in Big and Little Wong Tin Bar in 1962 at age 8. Chan then met Sammo Hung and the two became close friends, both learning Hapkido from Grandmaster Jin Pal Kim. Jackie Chan was able to translate his martial arts training into film, becoming a stuntman and martial arts choreographer. It was during this time that Jackie Chan worked on Bruce Lee's films Fist of Fury and Enter the Dragon. Jackie Chan's first big break came with the 1978 film Snake in the Eagle's Shadow. It was during this film that Chan was given creative control over his stunt work. This film would help establish the comedic kung fu genre and would be relatively successful. Jackie Chan would first achieve mainstream success with the 1978 film Drunken Master, which earned over $16.5 million at the box office, over $76 million in 2023. This film would propel Chan to success in Asia, which would lead to Hollywood films as well. In 1980, Jackie Chan would star in The Big Brawl, his first Hollywood film. This film would be successful as well, earning over $21 million, over $78 million in 2023. Chan would also have a role in 1981's Cannonball Run. While Chan was not the star of the film, especially the outtakes shown at the end, would have an impact on Jackie Chan's career. In 1984, Jackie Chan, along with friends Sammo Hung and Yuen Biao, would star in Wheels on Meals. This Hong Kong film would be relatively successful, particularly in East Asia, earning around $13 million, over $37 million in 2023. It was well received by critics as well. In Japan, this film was known as Spartan X, and just like Cannonball Run, this film would include outtakes during the end credits, which would become an iconic part of Jackie Chan's films. It is Spartan X that would inspire Kung Fu Master. Kung Fu Master would be developed by Irem. We have talked about Irem before. They were responsible for Moon Patrol. For Kung Fu Master, Irem turned to Takashi Nishiyama. Nishiyama was also the designer for Moon Patrol. Nishiyama was inspired by the final part of Spartan X, where Jackie Chan's character, Thomas, climbs a Spanish castle to rescue Sylvia, the love interest of the film. Nishiyama was also inspired by Bruce Lee's Game of Death, particularly with the idea of the protagonist fighting his way up 5 levels of a pagoda. The main idea for this game was to combine the rhythm of a shooting game with the fighting of these films. The music of the game would be created by Masato Ishizaki. Ishizaki had to convince Nishiyama to allow the melody to be included, as Nishiyama felt the sound effects alone would be more impressive. Ishizaki would win the argument, and the melody was included. Kung Fu Master is a side-scrolling action game. The player plays as Thomas, who must fight his way through many enemies on 5 different levels of the Devil's Temple. Thomas can punch and kick, and can take quite a few hits. Thomas has a health meter, and if that meter is depleted, the player will lose a life. The other health bar at the top of the screen represents the boss's health. Each level has a boss, known as the Sons of the Devil, at the end. When Thomas reaches the boss, the game turns into a one-on-one fighting game. The bosses are individually known as Stick Fighter, Boomerang Fighter, Giant, Black Magician, and the final boss, Mr. X. If the player is able to defeat Mr. X, Thomas will rescue Sylvia, and the game will restart at a higher difficulty. Irem released Kung Fu Master to Japanese arcades on November 24, 1984. In Japan, this game would be known as Spartan X, officially licensed from the film. Data East would release the game to North American arcades in late 1984, now known as Kung Fu Master, with the game no longer having the Spartan X license. Irem would release the game in Europe in 1985. That is a brief backstory to Kung Fu Master. With that now told, it's time to play the game for ourselves. A Kung Fu Master, Thomas, and Sylvia were suddenly attacked by several unknown guys. Sylvia was kidnapped by them. Later, Thomas found a letter from X. He is an inhabitant of the Devil's Temple. And here we are in the game. This is Kung Fu Master. Not the best opening story that we've ever had, but it is something. There is some plot in this game. Here is Thomas. We can play as Thomas and move to the left, punch and kick. There's not a lot going on in terms of controls. I can do high kicks, regular kicks, and low kicks. High punches, regular punches, and low punches. And enemies will grab you, and when that happens, you get drained of your health. So you don't want that to happen. Your main goal is basically to go left and not let people grab you. As you might be able to tell from the demo not doing well, the game's hard, and I'm not going to be particularly good at the game. Honestly, if I can make it past the first floor, I'm going to call that a victory. But with that said, let's go ahead and get in, see what I can do. Your love, Sylvia, is in custody now. If you want to save your dear Sylvia's life, come to the Devil's Temple at once. 5 sons of the devil will entertain you. Ooh. I'm gonna be entertained. All right, as we get a good little jingle. I do like the melody in this one. And then, like I said, your main goal is left. Killing enemies is just stopping you from going left. You wanna go left. Like as quickly as you can. At least on this floor. Ah! No, I've been grabbed. Okay. No. Okay, we got both of the knife-throwing guys. That's the hardest part, but I do have only half of my HP left. I should be able to make it to the stick guy pretty soon here. There he is. No, I've been grabbed, and then the stick guy got me! How dare you. Stickman is the end of the first floor. I think he's technically called, like, the Stick Master. I have it in my notes, but I don't have my notes in front of me now. Let's just try to make it to the end and get back to Stickman. Yeah, I like kicking. You get less points for it. No! They grabbed me to death! Kicking has a higher range, but it gives you less points. Because I don't care about points, I don't mind kicking my whole way to victory. Like, just stay back. Ah. Just stick and move the whole way. No! No, and I'm dead. Just not enough time to react? Like I said, if I can make it past the first boss, I will call that a victory. And I'm going to keep going until I can do it. Yes, 5 sons of the devil will entertain you. I was not entertained by Stickman. Let's see here. Like I said, just go to the left. There are 2 knife throwers. They're the biggest problem on this first floor, but you know, don't underestimate the difficulty of these grabbers. There we go. Okay. So far, so good. Now, punching does do more damage. So I might want to punch against the boss, but like I said, less range. Wait, there's another one? Okay. 1,000 points for that. Where's... I keep on expecting the stick guy to show up. There he is. Alright, we got him! And I did it! We get a little victory jingle. I get bonus points for how much health I had, how much time is left. And we made it to the second floor. And now on even floors, you have to worry about falling pots and things like that. I thought I could kick the snakes. And down I go again. Oh, I have little practice on the second floor. All right, we'll kick them as they drop. Oh, I thought I ducked in time. And that's the game. Yeah, I have no skills at the second floor. I am happy to have made the high scoring list at all. So let's go ahead and put in my initials. Lucky number 13 for me. I'm gonna call that a victory. And I think we are good here. That is basically the game. There's not a lot to it. So me even making it to the second floor, I'm gonna consider a victory. It only took me 2 tries and then I just absolutely bombed at the second floor. I have no chance of doing that until I start seriously practicing it. But I think that is the game played. So with the game played, let's talk about how it holds up today. Playing the game today, I do have to say that I did have fun playing Kung Fu Master for at least a bit of time. It's not a game that I could sink a lot of time into simply because it is really simple and basic. You move forward, you punch, you kick, that's about it. You can jump and go in a direction, but you have to be walking 3 steps before you can make the jump in that direction, and I didn't really talk about that, but that is the mechanic there. It takes a lot for you to jump diagonally. You can just jump straight up and down much more often and much more easily. But the game is fun. I think that it is foundational, as we'll talk about a little bit later, to several different kind of specific genres, but overall we're talking about having waves of enemies come at you and you taking them out one by one with your punches and kicks. And that is something that we haven't seen before, and I am a fan of that. With that said, because this is one of the first ones, or possibly the first one that you do this way, it's no surprises that the genre kind of grows and expands, and there are better examples of this type of genre out there. And we'll talk about the names and all that in a bit. But overall, I think the game does hold up well. If you are a fan of any sort of fighting games or martial arts games, or even interested in Jackie Chan himself, this game does hold a lot for you, and I would recommend it to people that are interested in any of those things. You probably already know if you are interested in playing Kung Fu Master. Maybe you want to be able to make it all the way to the end. Just expect a bit of frustration, because there are definitely some times that characters will come on screen, throw things at you, and you don't really have time to react. You're already in the middle of doing a move, and oh, well, I guess I'm gonna get hit by that and die. That just kind of happens in this game. Overall, I would say that the graphics are really good for the time. Everything looks like it's supposed to. We have the snakes, we have the dragons, the pots, we have the enemies, the character, the pagoda. Everything looks really good. The sound is also really good. I do enjoy that jingle, melody, whatever you want to call it, the background kind of baseline, I think adds a lot to the game, and I'm glad that Ishizaki won that argument and it got included. And then overall replayability, do I want to go back and play it? Not particularly, but I could see how a lot of people would want to go back and play it. So if you are interested in this type of game, this game probably holds something for you. I would recommend the arcade version. And we'll talk about ports for this game later. It does get ports. But I would recommend the arcade version. It is the original. And I think it is worthy of your time. And that's my modern take on the game. When the game was released, Kung Fu Master would prove to be popular. In America, Kung Fu Master would be the second highest grossing arcade game of 1985. The game would prove to be popular in Japan as well, topping the sales charts for 2 months in 1985. critics also seem to enjoy the game, particularly enjoying the pace and gameplay of the game. Kung Fu Master would prove to be very influential. It is often seen as the first game in a new genre known as the brawler genre. It is also considered the first beat-em-up game, although it should be noted that neither of these titles would be used in 1984. As an innovator, the game would see a multitude of imitators and spiritual successors. It would also see ports and direct sequels. We will keep an eye on some of these as we continue. Kung Fu Master's impact would also reach other industries, having an impact on manga and even on film. We will keep an eye on these in the future as well. As for Takashi Nishiyama, he would continue to create video games, although he would leave Irem before Kung Fu Master was released. We will hear from Takashi Nishiyama again. We will also hear from Masato Ishizaki again in the future as well, as he would continue to work at Irem. As for Jackie Chan, this would not be the only time that Jackie Chan had a direct impact on video games, so we will hear from Jackie Chan again as well. That will do it for the story of Kung Fu Master for now. My name is Baller Scuba. This has been Video Games Over Time. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you in our next video when we go for a ride.